So it's Harding, lead the GOP.
In the rankings of American presidents, Warren Gamaliel Harding often comes in first, from the bottom. Even though Harding was elected in the biggest landslide up to that point, and even though he and his dog Laddie Boy remained immensely popular in office, Harding today is remembered, if at all, for his womanizing and for the scandals that engulfed his administration after he died suddenly in 1923, poisoned, some believe, by his wife.
These are the original steps here.
But in Warren Harding's hometown of Marion, Ohio, the favorite son gets more favorable treatment.
So this is Mr. and Mrs. Harding's home here.
Harding Home tour guide or docent Sherry Hall sees it as her job to set the record straight.
He was not poisoned, as you might hear.
His wife didn't kill him.
His wife did not kill him. That was a totally made up story.
In fact, says Hall, Warren and Florence Harding were very much a team during the 1920 presidential campaign. When the world beat a path to the Hardings' doorstep, literally.
It was not unusual for 10,000 people to gather before the house.
Hollywood stars came to Marion, athletes too. Al Jolson even wrote a song for the campaign and played Warren Harding's porch. 95-year-old Trella Romine had a front row seat.
When I was 4 years old, I shook hands with Harding right over the banister out here.
When you were 4 years old, you shook hands with him.
You want to shake hands with the hand that shook hands with Harding?
Wow, that is great. That's amazing.
I was scared, you know. But when I looked up at his face, it was such a kind face. So I just stuck my hand out and made history.
I'm sorry to get all tabloid with you, but do you think that Warren Harding was a womanizer?
I'm in no position to answer that question.
Okay, you're taking the fifth.
Yes.
There's little doubt that Harding was at best negligent in supervising his administration. Several of his appointees, including a cabinet member, went to jail. But students from Harding High prefer to accentuate the positive.
His presidential election was the first election that women voted in.
He was the one of the presidents that helped start getting veterans health benefits.
President Harding was the only president to be elected on his birthday.
Well, this is Warren Harding's inaugural suit. He was always described as being a very natty dresser.
Here are Warren Harding's golf clubs, his briefcase, his cigars, even his shoes.
He did have the biggest feet of any president, right?
Size 12.
Size 12? I thought it was 14 and a half.
About 12 now.
Yep, just the facts, ma'am.
We'll lay it out. Then we want you, the visitor, to make your own decision.
So you're not just a docent, you're also a defense attorney.
Harding was the first president to visit Alaska. He died on the way back. Thousands lined the streets to mourn as his body made its way home to Marion, where the town built a monument for him. When President Harding died, the scandals that would define his presidency hadn't yet come to light. He was still a popular guy. Hence, the size of this monument. It's big. A bit grandiose, right? Until you consider that Warren G. Harding was a small-town boy who made it to the White House. No matter what, that's a big deal.
Warren Harding, you're the man for us.